frozen shoulder, also known as adhesive capsulitis, can emerge suddenly or follow an injury, causing intense pain and restricting the range of motion in the shoulder joint. Frozen shoulder originates in the shoulder capsule, the connective tissue around the joint, specifically where the head of the humerus fits into the shoulder blade's socket. Individuals may wake up one day with intense shoulder pain, and over the next few weeks, the joint stiffens, severely compromising range of motion. The condition progresses through three stages. In the initial, freezing phase, any movement of the shoulder causes pain, and the shoulder's ability to move becomes limited. The frozen stage follows, marked by increased inflammation that thickens the capsule. Pain might lessen during this stage. However, the shoulder becomes stiffer. The third stage, the thawing phase, brings a gradual improvement to the shoulder's range of motion. The duration of each stage varies among individuals, but the condition can take 6 months to 2 years or longer to resolve. Treatment for frozen shoulder usually starts with anti-inflammatory medication, followed by gentle stretching to control pain and restore motion. Corticosteroid injections may be recommended to help reduce pain and inflammation. They may help shoulder mobility improve more quickly than waiting for the condition to resolve on its own. Physical therapy can help increase your range of motion, but a frozen shoulder can take a year or more to get better. But if treatment is not helping, surgery is sometimes done to loosen some of the tight tissues around the shoulder. Capsular release is an arthroscopic procedure to cut the tight capsular tissues surrounding the shoulder joint, allowing the shoulder to move more freely. The exact causes of frozen shoulder are idiopathic or not fully understood. Inflammation likely plays a role, triggering the release of chemicals that irritate the joint, causing pain and leading to stiffness, freezing, and scarring. Certain factors increase the risk for developing this condition. Research reveals that diabetes increases the risk fivefold, while thyroid disorders contribute to a threefold higher risk, more common in women. Frozen shoulder can also follow breast cancer treatment or heart surgery. Frozen shoulder can develop after a shoulder has been immobilized due to a shoulder surgery, a fracture, or other injury. Having patients move their shoulders soon after injury or surgery can help prevent this complication. Additionally, it is important to keep your shoulders flexible as you age. Choose daily stretches and exercises that move shoulder joints through their full range of motion. Lastly, evaluate your diet and make any needed adjustments to support healthy joints and reduce inflammation. Support for this video is provided by Octo Health. For a 20% discount on all products, enter code DECIDE. Learn more in the description below and subscribe to our channel for more 3D health content.